Namaste. Welcome back to SRMD Yoga. So let's welcome the splendor of spring through an invigorating asana sequence. Open your hearts and feel revived and energized once again through this blossoming flow. Let's get started. Roll your shoulders back. Back is straight. Connect to your body. We gently close the eyes. Let's bring the hands folded in front of the heart center. In a very humble way, let's chant three ohms and the opening Guru Mantra. Breathing in. Sakshat Parabrahma Tasmay Shri Gurave Namaha. So let's start with our first warm-up. Breathing in, warming up the neck. Make circular movements with your nose towards the right. As big circles as you can. And now move in the opposite direction. Loosening up all the muscles in the neck. Once completed, just stay down for a moment, centering yourself, and slowly bring the head back up. And now for some shoulder rolls, making big circular movements in your shoulders, rolling them back. And now go in the opposite direction. Excellent. Let's take the hands in cactus position and raise them up and bring them back down. Coordinate this with your breath. Breathing in as you go up, breathing out as you come down. And now giving yourself a nice big hug, stretching your back muscles. Breathing in, open up your hands, stretching the chest, breathing out, stretching the back muscles. Breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, open up, allow your heart to expand, and breathing out, giving yourself a big dose of love. And now one final time, as far as you can. And now closing in and giving yourself some love. Excellent. Okay, let's bring our legs into the lotus position, Padmasana. Palms facing down. We will do upper body rotations. So breathing in, go behind. Breathing out, extend forward. Now towards the right, breathing in, half circle, and breathing out, complete that circle. Let's go 4 more times with the breath. Move consciously along with the breath. Enjoy the movement as much as you can. Make as big circles as you can. And now let's go in the opposite direction. Final round, just stay down for a moment as you center and balance yourself. And whenever you feel centered, you can slowly come back out. And now, come onto your fours. We will start with the cat-cow. Breathing in, looking up, arching your back. Breathing out, round the back. A few more times on your own with the breath. Allowing that cerebrospinal fluid to move through the body, activating the different centers of the brain, allowing your blood flow and your nervous system to activate. Excellent. Let's take the right leg back, parallel to the ground. Toes are pointed outwards. Look forward, lift the chest, hold here and breathe. And now bring the knee to the chest, forehead to the knee. Hold this. And let's chain the leg now. Left leg back. Look up, lift the chest. Have a gentle smile on your face. And now, knee to the chest, forehead to the knee. And relax. Now we will do a hip opening movement. So, making big circular movements with your right knee, 5 times clockwise and 5 times anti-clockwise. Make as big circles as you can. And now, in the opposite direction. And once you finish 5 with the right leg, let's repeat with the left leg. Make as big circles as you can. And now opposite direction. And you can relax. Let's come up on the knees for the camel pose, Ustrasana. Hands on the waist. Push your thighs forward, drop your head back. Feel that big stretch in your chest, shoulders. Relax here and breathe. And now slowly coming out, let's do the counter pose, which is the child's pose or Balasana. Let's repeat the camel pose one more time. This time tucking your toes in and see if you can grab your heels as you get into the final pose. Allow yourself to relax in the pose as you breathe. And now, let's take the counter one more time. So this time the counter will be puppy pose. So lifting the hips off the ground and the chest is dropping onto the mat. Feel that deep stretch in your back muscles. Drop your chest a little more. And now interlock your hands, lifting them up in prayer position. This will give you a deeper stretch. And you can slowly come out and sit in Vajrasana. And the next pose we will do is going to be the Adho Mukha Svanasana, or the downward facing dog. So lift the knees off the mat, pushing the ground with your hands. Try to bring the heels closer to the ground. And just breathe here, allowing all your muscles to stretch, getting that deep stretch in your hamstrings. From here, we will do a single leg downward facing dog. And now bending the knee, and drop this right knee over the left side of the body, feeling that stretch on the right side body. And slowly bringing the leg back down, we will repeat the same with the left side, three-legged dog. And then you can bend that left knee, dropping the knee over the right side, feeling that stretch. And now coming into Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, or upward facing dog. We will do this combination two more times, from Adho Mukha Svanasana to Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. To Adho Mukha, and Urdhva Mukha. And from here, come back into Vajrasana. From here, stretch one leg out. We will do the Triang Mukha Ekpad Paschimottanasana. So the left leg is folded back and bend forward towards your right leg. Spend a few moments here, breathing and relaxing the entire body. Slowly release and let's go back into single leg hero pose. And slowly coming out and let's chain the leg. So Triang Mukha Ekpad Paschimottanasana on the right side, breathing in and extend forward. And then slowly going back to single leg Virasana. Thank you. slowly lifting yourself back up and sit in Sukhasana. From here, come back into downward facing dog. Walking back into Malasana or a sumo squat. Bring your hands in Namaste, Pranamasana. Straighten your back and just relax in this pose. And from Malasana, let's come into Falakasana. The entire body in one straight line. Tighten your core here. And then let's bring the left leg down for a Vasishtasana. Looking at the right palm. Feel that side body stretch. And from here straight away into Skandasana. Straighten your back. Breathe here for a few times. Now shift Skandasana on the other side, maintain your balance. And now performing Vasishtasana on this side. Feeling that side body stretch. And now coming back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Hold this pose. And now come down into Ashtanga Namaskar. Drop the chest to the ground, lift the hips up. Breathing in, we're going to come into Bhujangasana, Cobra Pose. Roll the shoulders back, lift the chest, push the ground. This is a very effective pose to stretch your abdominal muscles. And now, lifting yourself up, we're going to come into Anjaneyasana. Raising the hands up and bend back for that full expression of the pose. Hold it and breathe. Bring the hands back down and shift back into the half split. Chain the side, come back into downward dog, and now bring the left leg forward, starting with Anjaneyasana. Hands raised up, bend back, bring your hands back down, shifting back to the half split. Coming back into downward facing dog. Walking forward. And come into a nice Padhastasana. Grabbing your big toe with your index and middle finger, pull your upper body down. Feel that deep stretch in your hamstrings. And now you can slowly lift yourself back up. From here, we will do Prasarita Pada Uttanasana. So, extend your legs wide and breathing in, looking up, breathing out, extend forward. Bring yourself into a nice forward fold. Pull your upper body down. using the arms. And now breathing in, halfway come up, interlock your fingers and coming back down for Prasarita C. Go as deep into the stretch as you can. And now placing both the hands down, raise your right hand up and twist your upper body. This is a variation. Looking up at the palm, breathe here. And now bring the right hand down and raise the left hand up, twisting towards the left side. Let's come back down, bring the palms back down, and we will do a variation of Parshvottanasana. Both the palms on the ground, both the knees are straight, bending towards the right knee. From here, come into Trikonasana, lift the left hand up. Slowly shift the side and come on the left side now. And now into Trikonasana. And now slowly lift yourself back up and move into the reverse warrior. Change the side, reverse warrior on the other side, looking up at the palm, and now you can relax and jump and come back to Samasthiti. And come to the top of your mat, back to downward facing dog. Breathe here, allowing everything to stretch out. Hold this pose. And now come down into Ashtang Namaskar. Drop the chest to the ground, lift the hips up. Breathing in, we're going to come into Bhujangasana, Cobra pose. Roll the shoulders back, lift the chest, push the ground. This is a very effective pose to stretch your abdominal muscles. And now, lifting yourself up, we're going to come into Anjaneyasana. Raising the hands up and bend back for that full expression of the pose. Hold it and breathe. Back down and shift back into the half split. Let's chain the side, come back into downward dog, and now bring the left leg forward. Starting with Anjaneyasana. Hands raised up, bend back. Bring your hands back down, shifting back to the half split. Facing dog. Walking forward and come into a nice Padhastasana. grabbing your big toe with your index and middle finger, pull your upper body down. Feel that deep stretch in your hamstrings. And now you can slowly lift yourself back up. From here, we will do Prasarita Pada Uttanasana. So, extend your legs wide and breathing in, looking up, breathing out, extend forward. Bring yourself into a nice forward fold. Pull your upper body down using the arms. And now breathing in, halfway come up, interlock your fingers and coming back down for Prasarita C. Go as deep into the stretch as you can. And now placing both the hands down, raise your right hand up and twist your upper body. This is a variation. Looking up at the palm, breathe here. And now bring the right hand down and raise the left hand up, twisting towards the left side. Let's come back down, bring the palms back down, and we will do a variation of Parshvottanasana. Both the palms on the ground, both the knees are straight, bending towards the right knee. From here, come into Trikonasana, lift the left hand up. Slowly shift the side and come on the left side now. And now into Trikonasana. And now slowly lift yourself back up and move into the reverse warrior. Change the side, reverse warrior on the other side, looking up at the palm. And now you can relax and jump and come back to Samasthiti. And come to the top of your mat, back to downward facing dog. Breathe here, allowing everything to stretch out. And come and sit in Sukhasana. And we will do a seated practice holding the Padma Mudra. So bring your hands in a lotus-like posture, allowing the mind to settle down. Allow yourself to feel grounded in this moment. And let's do a short guided meditation. Imagine yourself to be a blossoming lotus in a peaceful lake. You may visualize your body has become a white lotus in this pristine lake. In spite of all the fish, the moss, any other insects flying about, you are blossoming in this beautiful lake, untouched by anything and everything happening around you. Day becomes night, and night becomes day. But you, this beautiful lotus, are untouched, unmoved, unaffected. Allow yourself to embody this feeling of being this beautiful, untouched flower, radiating beauty, grace, and peace. In this very moment, everything is perfect, just the way it is supposed to be. Allow these words to go deep into your mind and into your heart. I am unaffected by everything happening around me. I stay rooted in my divine, pure nature. In the middle of all activities of the day, I stay graceful and I radiate only peace, only joy, only love. And so be it. Very slowly, you can bring your hands back down. Let's slowly bring ourselves into the next pose, which is called Viksit Kamalasana, meaning the bloomed or blossomed lotus pose. So bring your hands in this position and raise your legs and place them on the outside of the hands. With so much stillness and silence within, this will be a little easier to perform than on a usual day. Even if you lose balance, just lovingly bring yourself back. And now let's move into Upavishta Konasana. So legs stretched out. Stretch your hands forward. And now let's go into Parivrit Upavishta Konasana. Towards the side. And let's move to the other side now. And slowly bringing yourself back into Sukhasana. And we will come into Matsyendra Asana. It's a spinal twist. The left leg down, right foot over the left side. And go into the twist. And now release the pose. Let's chain the side. Spinal twist on the other side. From here, we will do the seated pigeon. So create some distance between your body and your feet. Left leg down, right foot on top of the left knee. And just extend forward, dropping down and relax. Breathing in, slowly come back and let's change the side. And you can slowly come back out and release. Let's take a side body stretch. So bring your right hand down, raise the left hand, looking up at the palm. And let's repeat the same on the other side. And slowly coming back to Sukhasana. And now, let's lie down on our back, coming into Pavan Muktasana, hugging both the knees to the chest. And let's take Urdhva Dhanurasana, lifting the upper body off the mat, pushing the ground with your hands and the feet. Feeling that stretch in every muscle in the body. And now slowly bring yourself back down into Pavan Muktasana. Let's take one leg Pavan Muktasana, so stretching the left leg out, forehead to the right knee. And come into a spinal twist. Let's chain the side, forehead to the left knee. Come into a spinal twist. Let's lift the upper body up for glute bridge or setu bandhasan. Allow the energy to flow towards the heart, towards the brain, and slowly come back down into supta baddha konasan. Pull this feet towards your body and open up into Anand Balasana, happy baby. Let's prepare the body for Sarvangasana. Take a breath and lift your back, hips and legs off the mat. Try to make them as straight as you can and relax here, relaxing your body, relaxing your mind. And slowly come back down into the Shavasana. allowing your body and your mind to just let go and relax. Slowly coming back to the body, gently turning to the right side. Using the support of both your hands, you can sit up in any comfortable posture. Let's do the closing ceremony together, palms facing up. Let's bring the hands in Pranayama in front of the heart. We'll chant the mantra for sending peace and love to every being in the entire universe. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani paschantu, ma kaschit dukh bhag bhavet. Om shanti 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 hi. Feel ready, with a gentle smile on your face, bowing your head down, surrender yourself to God, and you can open your eyes. Namaste.